Hi guys, and welcome to my full build and final reveal video for the Airfix 172nd scale Orca Harrier GR3. This is an old kit, 1969 tooling. It's in a 1982 reboxing. There's the box art. It's the lid. Excuse me. That's one of the end panels. It's kit number 02072. Let's take a look at it in the box. As you can see, everything's loose. The decals were really dark and yellow, unusable. The horizontal stabilizers were missing, and the canopy wasn't very clear. It was misty and thick. So let's have a look at the build. So the fuselage aft's had the air intakes already glued in by the previous owner, but as you look on the inside, you can see it looked like they were done with a hot glue gun, made a real mess of it, and he'd attempted to glue the pilot in place as well. Well, first off for me was to rescribe all the raised panel lines. I used the raised lines as guides for the blade, and then when I'd scribed everything, I sanded down those raised lines, and then after that I got the parts together for sub assemblies, drop tanks, pylons, etc. Glued those together, put them on cocktail sticks. As you can see, there's a lot of overlap at the part line that needed sanding down. I then glued the upper and lower wing halves together, and then I followed that by priming parts and priming the inside of the fuselage halves. I then painted the pilot. He's got a hand missing, the right hand. Painted the jet turbine blade, the air intakes, and inside the fuselage halves. And then after that, I assembled the pilot and the jet turbine blade in position, and then glued the two halves together, fuselage halves together, clamped them. Put some pegs on the back end, the tail end, till it was all set, and then got the other parts, air intakes, wings, and Aiden gun pods. And as you can see, no horizontal stabilizers. So in the forum that this build is for, the 50th anniversary buddy build that I'm hosting, a good gentleman named Ross Medlock, he heard of my miss out. Excuse me, and he sent me some nice decals and some horizontal stabilizers so I could get on with the build. So thanks again, Ross, for doing that. There they are, the stabilizers in place, and then all the other parts ready to go. And then I masked the canopy, glued that in place, and then I cleaned the plane down and then primed everything. There's the model primed and all the peripheral parts with a grey Steinel Res primer. And after priming, when that was dry, I brush painted some pre-shading on. That's the bottom side. And then after that was dry, I airbrushed the white. I didn't have any white, I couldn't believe it. I usually have three or four pots, so it was a trip down to the Hobby Lobby store. They didn't have any Model Masters or Tamiya, so I got that Liquitex, which was in the artist section. And then after painting it white, I drew on the camouflage demarcation lines, and then painted on the slate grey colour. And that was followed by painting on the lights, painting the jet exhaust, and the little details that needed a bit of colour around the model. That's the underside. And when that was done, I painted the drop tanks, wheel bay doors, rocket pods, undercarriage, wheels, and then gave everything a gloss clear coat to make it ready for decals. And when it was set, decals were out, and the stuff I needed, solver set, and I decaled the model and the pylons. They're the pylons decaled. That's the starboard side, port side, And when all the decals were in place, I sealed those in with another gloss clear coat. And then it was on to weathering when that was dry. So I mixed a black oil paint with some odorless mineral spirits, a little bit of white to make a dark brown oil wash. Put that all over the model and the peripheral parts. Let it set for 45 minutes, then rubbed it off with kitchen roll and cotton buds. And after that, I mixed a greyish wash and put that over the slate grey to sort of add some toned down highlights. I then mixed some acrylic wash, give a reddish brown colour, and highlighted all the scribed panel lines. And then everything was sealed with a final matte clear coat. And then there was a light missing. It doesn't come with a rear light on the fuselage there, so I used a bit of PVA glue applied with a cocktail stick and then painted it red. After that, I put the underwing stores on, drop tanks, rocket pods, then glued in the undercarriage, the wheel bay doors, and then that rear brake, air brake door, and I scratch built the hydraulic cylinder for that. And the last things to do was to put on that scratch built light on the front of the wheel and the little antennas there. And that was it. That was the end of the build. So next thing to do, I thought, let's put this on a little base. So I decided to build a base. And the way I did that was I got myself a piece of foam board. I cut out a square, 11 by 11, I think it was. Then I marked out some demarcations for the runway, edges of the runway. Using some moldacene plaster mixed with water, I then sprayed scenic cement onto those edges and applied the plaster in place, let that set. I then took some foam board strips. I marked off some markings that would be equivalent to 2 feet spacings for 2 feet wide slabs, and there'll be edging stones for the runway. I cut them up. There's all the little bricks. I then glued those in place as edging stones. Next, I applied a AK Terrain's asphalt, brushed that on. It's a nice texture, but I thought it was too dark, so I mixed some RLM 66 Schwarz Grau with some sand, airbrushed that on to tone it down. I then wanted to put a stripe down the middle, yellow stripe. So I masked off, painted that on, and then marked the edges with a black marker pen. And then it was on to putting some turf onto the outside of the runway. Used some static grass flock, some mud. And then after that, I put on some baking powder to simulate snow. And this was all stuck in place with the Scenics glue. And then got a twig from outside and screwed it from the underside. Screwed in, self-tapping screw into the bark to create a little tree. So that was it, guys. That was the end of the build. So let's move on to the final reveal. Talio, guys, chocks away.
We'll be right back.